Hey everyone, happy you tuned in to this edition of IFC UpNext, Inside the Latin American and Caribbean Creative Industries. I am Marc Alain Boucicault. I am the founder of Banj, the biggest tech hub in Haiti. Our mission has been around bringing entrepreneurs closer to the ecosystem, leveraging technology to create startups that can help fuel a global revolution. The creative industry has been one of the sectors that we've been focusing on. Some of our most exciting projects include the Creative Tech Lab, where we have allowed creatives and technologies to come together and create prototypes that could create a difference in the ecosystem. We have actually been able to scale that in the Caribbean by taking it to the country of Trinidad and Tobago. We help entrepreneurs get access to training, but also we help them connect with each other and also leverage networking. One of our projects right now is the Creatix, where we're aiming to train 150 creatives with the latest technologies, leveraging the latest platform like TikTok, using augmented reality, virtual reality, and the power of blockchain. So as an influencer myself, it's very important that creatives understand their role in the global economy, especially after COVID-19, where content have gone viral and people are using the internet more and more. Haitians can do that too. And one of the most amazing example is Gessica Généus. She has been able to take her movie, Frida, to the world and be able to share the Haitian story. So hey, guess who we have with you today? Gessica Généus. Join me in a casual conversation with Gessica right now. Gessica, very happy to have you here.
Happy to be with you, Mark.
So tell us how you started in film and what do you have going on right now?
Well, I started as an actress when I was 17 years old. I'm not gonna say how many years that is ago. So I played in a couple of films in Haiti. And then at some point, the industry, if we can call it like that, kind of collapsed. So I had to leave the country. It coincidenced also with the earthquake. So we had the earthquake, and right before that, all the movie theaters closed and nobody was actually producing anything. So I went to France. I studied for 3 years cinema, and then I came back home to open my production company because it's kind of hard to be an actress, a black actress, black female actress, black Haitian female actress in France. So I had to leave and come back to my country. So I came back, opened Aïs en Production, my production company, made like 20 to 25 portrait, short documentaries, made my first 52 documentaries, and then a documentary, and then I made Frida, my first feature film, yeah.
Yeah, we're gonna talk about Frida, of course, but let's step back a little bit. Tell us today, what's the industry looking like in Haiti?
Well, I think it's kind of how the population is behaving, you know, within the society. Everybody's trying to do what they can in the limitation of what they have as resources, because right now, as a human in Haiti, everything is limited for you. You cannot, you know, there's very few things that you can do. Even, you know, recreative space are almost non-existent in Port-au-Prince and outside of Haiti. You cannot leave Port-au-Prince right now. So there's a lot of social problem that, of course, affected everything. So right now I feel like there's a few of us that are still trying, that are still making, you know. There's a documentary festival every year, there's a theater film theater festival every year, there's different kind of, you know, small group activities everywhere. But I think where the gap is how do you transform that into money?
Yeah.
And how do you transform it into something that can generate money for people that are involved? Yeah.
That's a great point. And there's also so much to show about Haiti. Okay. Yet you made Frida, you made it to Cannes, and I guess the whole world started talking about Haiti and the movie.
And I remember on the 13th of October when I woke up in France, because the movie was about to come out in France after the Cannes Film Festival, all the headlines in France were like, Haiti mon amour, you know, Haiti, my love, the women of Haiti, the strong women of Port-au-Prince. Yeah. So you had like, I have goosebumps. You had like 10 or 15 headlines.
And it went in chain.
Yeah. And it was, yeah, you know, and it was all positive reviews. And I said, geez, like for me, that was as strong as the fact that the film was in the Cannes Film Festival. Mm-hmm. It was a great moment, you know, for us as a nation, yeah, to see ourselves the way we perceive ourselves, not the way, you know, journalists choose to perceive us, yeah.
But a movie like this, such exposure to the world, what do you think that does to a creative like you?
A lot. First of all, because we've never had a film with, you know, that has been shot with mostly Haitian crew, and this was crucial for me in the process. I wanted the crew to be mostly Haitian. I wanted the film to be in Creole. I wanted the film to be entirely shot in Port-au-Prince. And those were choices that were extremely hard to make. Yeah. Those are choices that actually stopped me from having a bunch, you know, a good part of my money to make my film. Because when you say all those aspects, people are like, oh, this film is not going anywhere.
That reminds me of what Haya was saying in a previous UpNext about, you know, defending more diversity behind the camera. Well, Gessica, thank you so much for participating in our conversation. Yeah. Know that we are very proud of you, and I hope that this conversation inspired many. Thank you for participating in our edition of UpNext. This is Inside the Latin America and Caribbean Creative Industries.
Thank you, Moi.